Welcome to Graffitti Cafe. I am your host, Fred Tavares, and today we have a special guest. His name is Vision.
How y'all doing? How you doing?
How you doing today, my brother?
Oh, you know, God is good all the time.
Yes,
all the time.
That's true. All the time. All day, every day. That's what I say
every
now.
Every day.
Right? But, I'm going to ask you some questions here, but how long have you been a born-again Christian?
Wow, I'm old now. I got saved in, I was in prison. I got saved in 2001.
Oh, okay, 2001. And how did that come about?
Well, yeah, I ended up in jail, right? I ended up in a cell. And prior to that, I had a discussion with this one guy about about Christ's deity. Like, I didn't believe that Christ was God. So what he did, me and him, we battled or whatever. So he tested me and he said, if you don't believe, why don't you read it yourself? So that was, God, you know how God gets to you. So I got in my cell and I started trying to debunk what he was saying. But in return, God was feeding me the word and I was getting fed with the word. And that's how I got, my spirituality. God, it was clear as day. It said about the Godhead. So the Godhead explained the Trinity, which is God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And finally, a light bulb went on in my head. And
yes. Sometimes we got to, it's tough love, and sometimes the Lord has to teach us that so that, sometimes we could be knuckleheads in our own mind, our own mindsets.
Oh, man.
We are human beings. But when he gets a hold of us, he gets a hold of us.
You and me. we talked a lot about our stories and our testimonies. And, I came a long ways. I come from a real impoverished city, Oakland, California. And my mom, she left and we migrated out to Fresno, California to get away from that. This is where I found God out of, even being there. I think, probably by the grace of God, we left there because I probably would end up probably dead or either in prison for the rest of my life if I would have stayed in Oakland. So,
yes, like you said, you was in prison or something like that. But there's always, God always has a plan. He has a plan for your future, He knew what he was doing.
Amen, amen.
It was just like a setup.
Holy Ghost setup is what we call it at Victory Outreach. It's a Holy Ghost setup. I went in there thinking I was going to be Mr. Superfly Snooker. I was going to be in there being the super warrior or whatever. And God just wiped all that out. I ended up doing Bible studies and, running with the sheep, as they say in prison, because to them, we're considered weak, so it was kind of hard for me to transition. And I was talking to you guys about that earlier, for some people that go to prison and it's like, oh, that's a way out, because they don't want to deal with the yard. But I like the yard. I like fighting. I like all that stuff. So it was hard for me to give it up,
I could relate. I could relate, man. I went through a lot of things like that, too. And like you said, I used to like to fight. But now, whatever, the enemy had intended for you to use for evil, now he's turned it around for good, right?
Amen. Yes, definitely. And it's amazing how when I look back and I look at how it all started, it's like a miracle, a modern day miracle. And we don't realize that we're in the midst of miracles every day.
Yes.
Every day is we see miracles. I see miracles just at my own house. If you're looking at it in the spiritual sense, you can see, me and my wife, we used to fight all the time, it's just one day it just stopped. I was praying about it. And I was like, Lord, if you don't do nothing, I'm gonna leave this lady. You better change her. But he wasn't changing her. He was changing me. So, and my house is at peace now, it's in by the grace of God.
Yes, at times we might think that it's somebody else, but it's us.
Man.
And we don't, sometimes we just don't see it because we are blind from it. And we won't accept it because we want to be hard up about
Macho
it.
Macho man, yeah.
Yeah, and but God, he's allowed us to be humble, and the answer is just, it's as easy as in reading the word, you know. And the Lord will just, you just, sometimes it's just opening up the Bible and all of a sudden it's just right there, right in your face, and you're like, whoa, the Lord just woke me up.
It's real, yep.
It was me all this time.
All the time is pointing the finger at somebody else and the things that we need to work on. And I was like, you know, God's been dealing with me on that. And then, you know, my church where I go to, Victory, obviously, I always talk about, they used to always talk about let God deal with you and he's dealing with you. And I didn't too much agree with that in the beginning because I felt like, you know, like God don't need to deal with me. I need to deal with myself. But they were actually right. God does need to deal with you and you need to deal with yourself. And it's not about, you know, dealing with other people or what other people are doing. So
thank God for creating tough women. Right?
Oh yeah, my wife's a battle cat. She's a good woman.
But the Lord uses them to open up our eyes and gives us the right wife and give us the right strong backbone, you know. And also the Lord could use her to open up our eyes and do great miracles. Like you said, there's been miracles. God is in the miracle business, and that's something that we can't deny.
Definitely can't, because it's like and it's happened with her too, you know what I mean? It's not just me. She's come to me and God's been dealing with her also, so you know. And it's just like crazy. It ain't crazy because it's the work of God, but it's amazing how God does that. He's like, he give me a time for when he's working on me, and he puts a little space between it so we don't start fighting, you know, and then he'll deal with me, and then he'll start dealing with her, and then he'll allow me to be able to see it, you know. And then I'm like, oh, God is doing something. Like you know he's actually doing something.
That's very true. I see it within my relationship with my wife, and man, I have a tough wife, and I'm grateful for that. But she also takes care of me, man, and the Lord has allowed her to reach me, talk to me. She's my backbone, and you know, and man, I don't know where I would be without the Lord and her. You know, the Lord always sends the right wife, right? And sometimes we just need that, you know.
He know we need those type of wives because we was a mess. You know what I mean? We was a mess. We can't have no lamb of a wife or a woman that's passive, or, you know, it won't work, you know. So he knows he has to put a woman in there that's strong, that's able to, you know, say, hey, look what you're doing. You know, is this what you want to do? That's what my wife does. She'll tell me. She'll call me out, and she's not scared, you know. And I respect that. You know, I respect that.
Yes, thank God for them great wives out there, them bold, strong wives, the ones that are always looking out for us, the ones that are always, you feel like you're getting punched in the gut, but hey, we need to open our eyes. We have a music video, it's called The Cure, and it's by Vision.
Amen.
So you came out with a new song called The Cure, right?
Right, right.
So what's the story behind this song?
You want to say a little something about it? Or?
Well, basically, it was inspired by what's going on with COVID. But at the same time, letting people know that through it all, Christ is the cure. So
that's right.
Me being an example of what a person looks like in humility, that's lost, that's wounded, that's torn apart. You know what I mean? I was representing that, and I was just allowing that to reflect on what's going on in the world, you know?
There is a lot of stuff going on in the world, and there's a lot of people that don't know, we're just looking up on Google, and my wife was looking up too, and she's all like, the number one thing that's going on Google that they're looking up right now is how to get healed, how to heal myself. You know, and God's still in the miracle business, and there's just a lot of people that just don't know. As amazingly as it could be, worldwide, people knowing about Christ, there's still some people that don't know about Christ and what abilities the Lord has and what he can do for you and how he can heal. You know, it's just all about the authority. If people don't recognize and don't know how to use God's authority to be able to heal or use God's authority to heal themselves, then they're not going to know. See, there's a lot of lack in the acknowledgement of, you know, how do you heal yourself? But it's not really you healing yourself. It's Christ. Through Christ, we could do all things. So that aspect of everything is that, you know, God is still in the miracle business, in the healing business, you know?
And you know what? It's kind of funny that you're talking about that, and we never even talked about doing the video, the cure, and God just lined it up just right now. I just thought about it. It's just man, wow, yeah.
Yes, I've seen a few videos, and I'm like, wow, all right. You know, I like it because it's not only that, but in order to reach the streets also, people need to be bold, and people that came from the streets and been through the things, you know, and how to touch people's lives, you know, through Christ, you know, and save souls, you know, that's the main thing, and showing people through your music that, hey, God did this for me, and he could do it for you too.
Amen.
Here's a music video, Sparrow.
Before we begin, y'all need to quit all them assumptions. Haters have a bloodthirst to take my life, request for a busting. My mom's a pop, see the race, no buster. When it's hell, the Holy Spirit ushers, I'm cuffing. All the powerful blood of Christ, vision knows all about being a child of God. Dogs is the price. Understand me, sucker. Defeat of my number one enemy be nothing. I gotta stay alive, remain wise, cause music is my life, has a new blessing in the oven. I remain safe, never did I leave the hood. Man, you can see the way this Christ in my thuggin'. Thug stays even hunting. I ain't worried about you uneducated clowns me mugging. My real ones got cap and gowns, they say gotten building hustling.
Every day's another struggle, ducking and dodging trouble. Uh-huh. Satan puts up hurdles, Christ fights all my battles. Yeah. Be careful the road you travel. Jesus the rock, Satan the gravel. The door is narrow, keep your eyes on the spell. Yeah. Home of the 6-4 in the Oakland Raiders. Satan leading people to the dark side like Darth Vader. When I first heard this track, it reminded me of how you wanted me to be. That you got me, I was so out of reach. Help me to overcome the attacks of the enemy. They come in threes, so I got on this beat to open eyes so they can see that it ain't about the streets. It's about who you are, not searching for fame, trying to be a rap star. Driving expensive cars won't get you far. You either end up dead or locked behind bars. Make you think who's really in charge. Jesus is Lord, shaking the binds of Satan. Maybe this song will change the situation. Give him praise without hesitation. It was never in my nature. Now I see the picture clear. Who's the creator? Died on the cross to send the Savior. More reason for me to thank him. Now say your prayer. Yeah. Keep your eye on the sparrow, keep your eye on the sparrow, yeah. Keep your eye on the sparrow, keep your eye on the sparrow.
spirit. Every day's another real struggle, ducking and dodging trouble. Satan puts up hurdles, Christ fights all my battles. Be careful the road you travel, Jesus the rock, Satan the gravel. The door is narrow, keep your eyes on the spell. Every day's another struggle, ducking and dodging trouble. Satan puts up hurdles, Christ fights all my battles. Be careful the road you travel, Jesus the rock, Satan the gravel. The door is narrow, keep your eyes on the spell.
So this is the music video Sparrow, and we have Vision and Aimez on this video. And, you know, so what were your thoughts when you were doing this video? I mean, when you wrote this song, what were your thoughts on this? Like,
actually, me and him drove around the city. We didn't even know. We didn't pretty much didn't know what we was going to do. You know, we was just waiting on God to, you know, and it just so happens some guy with the truck with the lights on it showed up, and if you look in the back of the video, like if we're in a carport, and in the back of me on my verse, you can see some birds flying in the background. It's just like when I go back and look at the video, I was like, wow, that's it, all came together. You know, God made it all come together.
Yes, God works in these mysterious ways, that's for sure. Sometimes it could be the littlest things. It could be a little thing, but in your mind, your thought is so big. The Lord opens it up, just like a mastermind. You know, all of a sudden you see things going on here, storylines all over the place, right? So, yes, I could see that because I do it all the time. And then by the time I get home, like, I forget about it. Like, what was I thinking about? Man, I'm trying to think about this more than anything. You know what I mean? Like, Lord, give me strength so I could remember, you know? So, Aimez, you grew up out here in Fresno, California, right?
Yes.
And you grew up in the neighborhoods. And tell me a little bit about what you got on your shirt here, Dog Life.
Basically, I'm a former Bulldog from Third and Grant on the east side of Fresno. And for a while now, the Lord's been tugging in my heart to use what the enemy, you know what I mean, meant for bad, and, you know, to turn it to good. You know, when the Bible says to take the foolish things of the world and confound it with the wise. So I use it towards the enemy, you know, after everything that's been done to my homies, from people being killed, locked up, and so forth, you know. So it's an attack on the enemy. And I'm believing that the Lord is going to take back the city the way he needs to, in Jesus' name.
Yeah, I could see that that sweater right there could explain a lot of fishing, you know, fishing for souls, fishing for people, you know, and people that could relate to what you've been through, your neighborhoods and all that, you know. And that's a very good strategy, well, of God. You know, it's just like in the word it says, be as swift as a serpent and as gentle as a dove, right? All these things just reminds us that it all comes to God's glory, you know. And, you know, it doesn't matter how you look, how you dress, and all these things, but we also know that Vision has a street ministry too, and I've seen it into action myself, you know, and you know, get to the point where he's not only doing his music or he's rapping up there about God or anything like that, but I know he does a great ministry where he's giving away certain things like bikes and backpacks and all these things. And, you know, can you explain a little bit about your street ministry?
Yeah, it's called Real Street Ministries. You can find it, you can Google it, realstreetministries.com. And basically it started in like 2 years ago. Last time I was on your show, we were just in doing the footwork, the paperwork and everything. So now we're a full-time 501c3. You can go to the website to get the music, get our music. And if you're looking for, you know, if you want to donate, you can donate to the ministry, because we do outreach. We do, you know, we just try to go out there and like Victory Outreach say, reach those treasures out of darkness. So that's what my ministry is. It's not Victory Outreach, but I got the same mentality as, you know.
Praise God. Yeah. Well, you came from Victory Outreach. Amen. So they lay, the Lord had you there to so you could learn and you could lay down a platform. Amen. You know, and praise God for Victory Outreach.
Amen. He has a, what you got, a website, huh?
Yeah, it's doglifefamily.com. I'm also a part of Rush Street Ministries. I got blessed to be the director. And, you know, so whatever needs to be done, I'm the guy.
He the man. He the man. He does graphics, all that, man. That's my man right there.
Praise God. We're going to end this show with a live performance with Vision and Amaz and Quiet Storm.
I remember growing up, it was rough. We had close to nothing. Mama worked hard every day to put food on a plate and make sure we had something.
We had something.
Gunshots out my window, wondering who won't see tomorrow. That's just how it go down in the hood. If I could change it, I would.
Yeah, coming up the way I did, made the man that I am. Sticking to the script, kept my mouth zip, fam. Remembering all the things that weren't seldom seen. Roaches next to the cereal bowl, know what I mean? Dope fiend round the corner, kids selling marijuana. Crystal coke pills, dust, getting money. Acting dummy, get that stoolie boo. Be a stoolie when the funeral. Mama try to protect me from the visual. Say my prayer day and night, case I take a flight. Headed towards the light with the dirt that's taken. Now save, now soft, fire me, never off. Fire man can't extinguish a flaming golf. Now I've grown up a bit smarter. Live with my father, home mama, snow my, I'm sorry, your honor. Gotta live a better life, stop acting trite. Life is a roll of dice, receive salvation for its goodbye. Goodbye.
I remember growing up, it was rough. We had close to nothing. Mama worked hard every day to put food on a plate and make sure we had something. Gunshots out my window, wondering who won't see tomorrow. This is how it go down in the hood.
Well.
If I could change it, I would.
Mama did her best, made sacrifices, took chances. My older brothers taught me about turf flag and get old like the modern day. Brown pride, Black Panthers. So many memories, so many caskets. Only the chosen few understand these tears behind these dark glasses. Many friends were gunned down and blasted. Must have forgiven stupid bastards. Ashes to ashes. Lord, I pray that this pain passes. Cause daily how the police harasses. This is how it goes down in the hood to a prop song. Man of daily hazards. Young bandits still searching, but choose not to see answers. Because they hooked on these evil cancers. Caring less if the health crashes. Homie, there's a better way. Let us pray, let this reach the masses.
I remember growing up, it was rough. We had close to nothing. Mama worked hard every day to put food on a plate and make sure we had something. Gunshots out my window, wondering who won't see tomorrow. That's just how it go down in the hood.
Down in the hood, yeah.
Couldn't afford nights, only fake Chuck Taylors. Didn't have steak or chicken, mama do with potatoes. I was a rolling stone, out there trying to be a player. So I hustled to feed my sisters, posted up on the stairs. America nightmare, dreams torn and tattered. Picture rocks on the block, I thought Black Lives Matter. Sleeping on warm mattress, found out they had rats in it. All I wanted to stack a grip, never in school, always delinquent. All my friends being answered, oh Jesus will come quick. God paid me a visit. Behind a penitentiary fence, transition wasn't easy. Came a bump, bruises and nicks. My strength lies in him, not behind the weight bench. The hood, I take you on to play at your own risk. Riches don't come easy, not by the twist of the wrist. It all comes with a price, it ain't worth dying to sin. In the hood, you won't win.
I remember growing up, it was rough. We had close to nothing. Mama worked hard every day to put food on a plate and make sure we had something. Gunshots out my window, wondering who won't see tomorrow. That's just how it go down in the hood. If I could change it, I would.
Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Graffiti Cafe. We'll see you next episode.